Welcome back to my channel. Now, in these periods of lockdown and not being able to work full time and working from home and having a little bit more time on our hands, people have been wanting to learn new skills. For example, I learned how to knit, but there's been lots of people asking how to do a handstand and learning to do those kinds of things and doing something, challenge their bodies to do something new. So I thought it'd be fun to teach you a few steps of how you can learn to do a handstand, not using a wall and just standing on your hands for as long as you like, walking around, a new party trick, whatever you want to call it. So, I'm going to go ahead and take you through. I've got 10 steps here, so hopefully, if you're able to do one of them, great. If you can do all 10, fantastic, you can probably already do a handstand. But I'm going to take you through a couple of the steps. So, step number one is a high plank hold. So, this is a high plank position. You can just hold it. Okay, so this is just starting to get you used to holding weight on your shoulders and your upper body while keeping a flat line, so that this, in theory, the flat line doesn't change when you're in a handstand. What changes is the angle of your shoulders, so that you're going to be putting all the weight through your shoulders. But doing this just helps strengthen your core and strengthen your shoulders to be able to do it. Step number two is to start to elevate those plank holds. So, same as what we were doing just now, but maybe put your feet on a sofa, or if you've got an extra bench, you can put it a little bit higher and gradually get a little bit higher. You can do it, for example, I've got a TV cabinet here, which I can put my feet on, and there we are, we're a little bit higher. So it's gonna put more pressure through your shoulders and through your wrists, and it just starts to slowly and gradually get your core and your shoulders developed, ready to do a handstand. Step number three. If you're finding those first two steps difficult, you can start to progress your shoulder stability and your shoulder strength by doing things like scap press-ups. So it's very similar to the plank positions that we've been in before, but what we're gonna do is gonna drop down in our shoulders and push up. Drop down, push up. So we're just trying to engage the muscles that we need to push our shoulders away from the ground. So, I mean, you can do it just like this. Then you can slowly make it out into your high plank position where you are doing these shoulder scaps, keeping your arms straight, but just moving in your shoulders and pushing everything and moving it away, so that that is it. Well, basically it's giving you the chance to get stronger shoulders. Step number four is to do the same thing we were doing on the floor, but overhead. So you're doing overhead shrugs, like so, but you can use a band, for example. Get the band around your feet, hold it above your head and press. Or you can get a carton of milk, a drinks bottle, for example, like so, and literally just press it above your head and do about 20 shrugs. You'll feel a little bit in your shoulders, and it's really just trying to strengthen your arms enough to be able to hold your body weight. Step number five is to start to be able to hold your body at an angle that is going to be where you're similar to a handstand position. So I don't know if any of you have done hammer press-ups before, but a hammer press-up is where you're in this kind of inverted position and then you do press-ups like so. That is starting to get you used to being able to do a handstand press-up. We just need to be able to hold it first. So if you can, get your bum in the air so that it's almost vertical, so that you're nearly in a handstand, but you're just holding your weight directly on your hands. If you need to be back a little bit, or you're out here, that's fine. Just go to where you can. But this is just starting to get you used to holding your weight on your hands at the angle that it would need to be if we were all the way up in a handstand. Now, some of you might be able to do this already, and that is a headstand. It's something that people learn in school and all that kind of stuff, but to do it safely, you want to be able to have as much support on the ground as possible. I like to do it in a bit of a, almost like a triangle position, like so. And you put your forehead, or like the crown of your, like not the crown, the bit here, don't know, it's not like the very front of your forehead, but just as it starts to go flat on the top, put that down on the ground. And for me, if you're a beginner, this is more of a yoga position to do a headstand in. If you bring your hands in front of your head like so, and you come up into your headstand, this just allows you to be a little bit more, having your weight a little bit more on your hands to have a bit more control of the balance. Now, you might not be able to do that, of course, just freestanding. So, do it where you've got a wall to lean on. You are going to need something to rest your head on so that it's not too hard. So you can use a towel, a yoga mat folded up a few times. But just get into position, kick up, put your feet on the wall, and you can just hold it. This just gets you used to being upside down because it can be quite daunting initially going upside down. So just holding, and you can start to like move your feet away from the wall a little bit and just do little movements to be able to get used to balancing on your own. The next thing is to start doing a handstand where you've got your hands on the floor like so, and you just walk your feet up the wall like this, get into a handstand and walk it back down to the floor, and then back up to a handstand and back down to the floor. That just gets you used to being again upside down on your hands so that you can get to the next stage in our handstand preparation. So once you've mastered all of those steps and you feel confident, then what the next thing I suggest you do is kick to a handstand against the wall. So start with your hands on the wall, like put your hands about like a hand width or hand length away from the wall, so you've got a bit of space to work with, and then just kick up into a handstand. Or get somebody to help you into this position. But once you're in this position, you are holding your body weight on your hands through your shoulders, and you want to be in a straight, long line and just hold it here. Just hold it here. When you're in your handstand, you're gonna have your hands like so, and just having your straight fingers is not gonna help you have much balance. So most divers and gymnasts will have their hands like so to be able to adjust. If you're falling over, you can press into the ground a little bit easier, like so. So you can practice that by just being on the floor, on your hands and knees, and you can literally just be on your hands and knees and rock back and forward. And as you're rocking backward and forth, you can then use your fingers to pull you back. You'll feel it in your forearms, and your fingers will push you back into that position. And that just allows you to control the balance when you are in your handstand. I know this is a random interlude into this, but the rest of the steps I filmed were blurry, so I'm going to film them again now. But yes, I'm in a different outfit. Yes, I'm sweaty. I'm just in a workout. But here's the next step. Next thing we're going to do, when you're against the wall, just start to take your feet away slowly but surely and eventually get to a nice solid balance. Here we go. Downstairs into the corridor because there's no room anywhere because Robbie's upstairs playing. Next step is just to kick to handstand and just try and keep going, and you'll eventually kick to a handstand and you'll be able to hold it. And finally, practice your handstand hold and keep practicing and practicing and practicing and practicing and practicing and practicing, and you'll get there in the end. That is how, well, some steps on your way to learning how to do a handstand. Hope that was helpful. Whew. Let me know if you need any more answers to any questions, and I'll answer them in the comments.